Hey, what's up, Alex here. What do I look out in my daily cleaning appliance? We are talking about daily here. Nobody is so free or very willing to spend their time and energy every day, 30 minutes to 1 hour, depending on the size of the house you need to clean. I believe everyone would rather spend their time to just rest, do the things you like, or watch this YouTube video. So the appliance, to me, cleaning performance-wise, they need not to be super powerful and detailed, but they must be effortless, fast, and also low maintenance. This is the Ecovex D-Bot T8, which I've been using for more than a month, replacing my faulty Roborock S5. Many of you are waiting for me to give a review of this robot vacuum ever since my reaction video on Aiken's house reno, but I want to use it for a period of time first before giving my review of it. Okay, first of all, this is not cheap if you compare with what is available in the market. Mine is the standard T8 model, which costs $599 currently in Shopee. There is the AIVI model, which is $50 more. I bought mine for less than $520 during a discount. The difference between these two models is the AIVI model comes with the add-on accessory for enhanced mopping, which I don't fancy because I don't use the mopping function at all, and a HD front-facing camera which allows you to catch a live video feed from the app, like a moving IP camera in the house. I don't really need these features, and another reason why I choose the non-AIVI model is because of the color. The top cover is in glossy white, body is in black, and the top of the LiDAR is like a rose gold color kind of finishing. It has two side brush, a main roller brush. The packaging also includes one set of spare side brush and a filter. Opening up the cover, you will find the bin, which I consider to be the standard size. Doesn't really matter if you have an auto empty station. Then on this side is the mopping feature. Robot vacuum is not meant to do heavy duty cleaning, so in terms of cleaning performance, I feel it serves its purpose well on a daily basis doing the general cleaning, which is mainly just dust and hair. In terms of the software app, it's really a much better user experience compared to the Roborock running on Mi Home. But having said that, typically for all these smart home apps, you just want to set it up once, and after that, you hardly ever need to use it again unless there are some issues and you need to check the logs. Inside the app, under the settings, you are able to switch on or off the features, setting your cleaning preference and sequence. Each of these zones are in a different color, and you can see that I set the robot to clean my master bedroom first, followed by the first common room, the corridor area, the kitchen and service yard, lastly the living room area. And not to forget that it integrates with Google Home by adding the Ecovex app. It is able to do those basic commands like start, stop, pause, and return to dock. Compared with the Roborock, I feel that Roborock is slightly smarter. There are a couple of instances where the T8 couldn't return to dock. I'm not sure why, it just keeps on circling around the charging dock. And also during the first initial mapping, it keeps trying to get into the study room even with my folding glass door closed. Somehow, it couldn't detect that there is a glass door in front of it and keeps trying to enter the room for a good 5 minutes before giving up. My must-have features of a robot vacuum now is it must be using LiDAR to map out your house, able to set those no-go lines or zones, good sensors or AI technology to avoid objects, detect carpets, and also an auto empty station, which is getting more common now. The auto empty station is just available in SG last month, so I'm like kind of waiting for more discount or the price to drop a little more because right now it's still quite expensive. I mentioned in the beginning of the video that a daily cleaning appliance must be effortless. That is why having this auto empty station is really good, as you just need to empty this once or twice per month. That is also why I don't use the mopping function at all, apart from the mopping problem I talked about before. I feel that a robot vacuum shouldn't require any kind of human intervention on a daily basis. The D-Bot T8 ticked all the boxes, and with the T9 that is just released, it has some new interesting features but not something I considered to be very important. You can check out the Singapore Ecovex website to find out more. Alright, so moving on, if vacuum robot is not an option for you but you still want a cleaning appliance that is able to do both vacuum and mop concurrently together, able to move by itself, save some effort required, like the Tineco Floor 1 S3 that I shared in my other video, today we are going to look at a close competitor to that, the HiZero. But first, a quick message from our sponsor. If you're looking for a small, powerful handheld vacuum cleaner, check out the all-new 2020 Opola 2-in-1 Air Duster and Vacuum, which is an excellent choice both for your home and your car. It comes with a 60,000 RPM motor, which you can keep it inside your car to vacuum the seats, dashboard, and those hard-to-reach or clean areas. At home, you can use it for your desk peripherals, computer, air conditioner, window frame, and many more. This is super portable and lightweight, comes with these two brush attachments, one for the blower and one for the vacuum. To interchange between these two functions, just simply turn the middle portion. One single button to control the speed you want and also to switch it on or off. Charging time for this is about 3 hours via mini USB, which means you can charge this with your computer, car charger, or even with a power bank. At full charge, the battery can last you about 30 minutes, which is enough for you to clean the whole interior of your car. There's no need to buy expensive air duster spray cans anymore because this Opola 2-in-1 cleaner can absolutely replace that. Check out the video link in the video description for more details. Look at all these comments in my cleaning appliance video talking about the HiZero. So I'm really curious how good it is. To be transparent with you, HiZero sent me this unit, but rest assured that they're watching this video at the same time as you. So it's all my honest opinion. In fact, they don't really seem to care what I'm going to say in this video. The HiZero retails at $699 now at the time of recording. It's even available at all the major mega electronic stores. Packaging includes the charging station, the cleaning solution, couple of spare trash tray, and a cleaning brush used for the maintenance, which I will talk about this later. Okay, let's talk about the exterior design first because I think it's very worth mentioning. The design is very clean, white glossy, and some black finishing, kind of similar color combi with my robot vacuum. And when you switch it on, it has this blue color lighting in the middle part and at the controls. The whole thing has like a very futuristic look to it. It's the hand stick design, that's why you can have it stand upright. They use a separate material for this handle grip part. I don't know how to describe to you, but this is really very comfortable to hold. This is like an ergonomic design with some specific positioning for the fingers this way. It's really good that the company really pay attention to such small detail. The HiZero is only applicable for hard floors like tiles, marble, or wooden, not suitable for carpets. So basically how it works is you fill up the clean water tank with tap or warm water. Once a while, you can also add in some of its cleaning solution, it's up to you. It will do vacuum and mopping concurrently. As you clean, the dirty water tank will be slowly filling up. Hairs and other kind of solid waste will be automatically separated and collected at the trash tray. Once the clean water tank is empty or the dirty water tank is full, it will automatically stop and indicate at the lighting controls. One of the cool features of the HiZero is the self-cleaning capability. Unlike the Tineco where you will initiate the self-clean process once you are done with the cleaning, the self-cleaning for HiZero is constantly ongoing while you are cleaning. So the only maintenance work you need to do is opening up this compartment to empty the solid trash tray, which is around once a week. The HiZero is also able to move by itself similarly to the Tineco, but I find that it moves a little bit too slow, while the Tineco I find it going a little too fast. Feels like I'm very picky here, but it will be good if the speed is somewhere in between the HiZero and the Tineco. There are a couple of things I don't like about the HiZero. I realize if the mopping roller is not wet enough, it will drain up the clean water tank super fast. The only situation that it's not wet is if you didn't use it for a few days. Then you will need to take the roller out, soak it for around 5 minutes before use. But this is not an issue if you are using this frequently or on a daily basis. Then another problem is due to the shape and design at the front, the mopping won't be able to reach the edges of the floor. I'm not sure whether you can see this clearly from the camera. There is actually a small gap from the mop to the skirting. But apart from this, overall, I feel this all-in-one vacuum is really quite good. It ticks all the boxes you want: cordless, good battery life, minimum effort, and low maintenance with its auto maneuver and self-cleaning function. And a bonus point is the cleaning performance is actually very good at handling solid and stubborn stains, which means it's not only good for daily cleaning, but also any ad hoc kind of scenario, like you spill your coffee or kids spill their food on the floor. For me personally, I will use it after I sweat a lot in my gym room, or after some cooking, you want to mop the kitchen a bit. So there you go, my recommended daily cleaning appliance is the Dbot T8 or T9, HiZero if you don't want a vacuum robot. But I would still recommend a vacuum robot if possible with all the must-have features that I mentioned earlier. It is arguably the best smart home appliance invented. Every day before I go out for lunch, I will start the vacuum. Then just nice when I'm back from lunch within an hour's time, it's done. But I understand not every house is robot friendly, maybe because you have simply too many things lying around, or your house reno design, you build platforms everywhere, like a platform bed in the bedrooms, or in the living room, you build platforms to segregate the sofa or dining area. That's why I don't do any platforms in my house. And a quick reno tip for robots here, make sure the furniture or carpentry you get for the sofa and bed frame have enough allowance for the robot to go underneath and clean. Okay, time for the giveaway announcement. So the two lucky winners for the TP-Link Deco M4 are Zerafi and Amos Tan. Drop me an email or DM me on our IG. My contact details can be found at the About page of my YouTube channel. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give a thumbs up to the video. That's the easiest way to support the channel. See you in the next one. Bye.